jokes of her husband being a just man and not willing to make her a public example was minded to put her away privately. But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is the Holy Ghost. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sin. Now all this was done that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the Lord by the prophet, saying, Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us. Then Joseph, being raised from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord had bidden him, and took unto him his wife, and knew her not till she was brought forth her firstborn son, and he called his name Jesus. Amen. And so for the operational verse, if I could, I want us to say verse 21, and she shall bring forth a son, and I do believe Pastor said, and her seed shall come forth. And it also said, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. And I believe Pastor David said it's going to work out for your good. Amen. Amen. You may be seated in the household of faith. So if I had to sit here and I had to name it, you would ask your neighbor, what is his name? And then tell your other neighbor, his name is Jesus. Amen. Now I just want to tell you on that note, it's time to celebrate on today. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 That's not the response that I really wanted to hear. Amen. That's not the response, because there's a certain place that we need to go today. Amen. Because I heard Pastor say breakthrough, and I heard Pastor say deliverance. Amen. And that's why that verse 34, Psalms 34, verse 1 and 2 was so pivotal. I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. We're not going into the new year with the same old thing, but we're going out of this year with a bang. Amen. We're going to bless him because he's been good. We're going to bless him because he's been kind. We're going to bless him because he's merciful, and he's gracious, and he's wonderful, and he's a mighty God, and he's a counselor, and he's the Prince of Peace, and the government was up upon his shoulders. This is why we're going to bless the Lord.
Hallelujah.
At all times. And his praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make her boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. I need you to magnify the Lord with me on today, and I need you to exalt his name together. Amen. Amen. If we just get two or three few good men who would praise the Lord together, I believe that a sound can conjure up that will provoke another set of people. Amen. To praise the Lord freely. Amen. So if I got two or three good people on this side, just start saying hallelujah and thank you, Jesus, and bless the Lord. It's going to make these people say hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, and bless the Lord. I believe that the middle row's going to stand up and shall mock the Lord. I believe that the middle row's going to stand up and wave their hands. I believe that the middle row is going to give God some praise. I'll bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. I know you don't understand why you need to praise him, but he sent his son to come down and see about me and you. He sent his son to be the Savior, to be the Christ for you and I, the one who knew no sin. He came sin for you and I. That's the one I'm talking about, the lily of the valley. The bright morning star. I'm talking about the wrongs of Sharon. When we look back over the year and see that it was nobody but God.
Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
As I was journeying through some scriptures on today, he was talking about how the Lord was sent here to be our Savior. Luke 2 and 11 was talking about, for unto us is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. Acts 5 and 31 said, him hath God exalted with his right hand to be a prince and a savior, for to give repentance to Israel and forgiveness of sin. That's something to shout about. That's something to be thankful about. That's something that's going to make me keep the praises of God on my lips continually. Amen. Because it also let me know that he became man's substitute. How many of you know back in the Old Testament, a lot of us would have been like Lot's wife, and we would have turned around, and it would have been out of sight, and it would have been out of mind. But as I was reading Isaiah 53 and 5, the Bible said that he was wounded for our transgressions, and he was bruised for our iniquities, and the chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. He became the substitute. Ain't none of y'all died up on the cross for me. Amen. He became the substitute. Ain't nobody up here died for you, but he became the substitute. We need to know, amen, what the real reason of the season is. It's called Jesus. J-E-S-U-S. I know back in the day, amen, that was a common name, amen. But that's not the same Jesus I'm talking about. I'm talking about Jesus, amen, the bright and morning star. I'm talking about Jesus, because at the name of Jesus, every knee is going to bow, every tongue is going to confess, oh, Jesus is Lord. That's what the reason for the season is about on today. I know some of y'all trying to figure out, how did I end up in this same place again? How did I end up in that same rut again? We got our priorities off. We ain't put the right person first. We got caught up in the things of the world. We got caught up in the lust of the flesh. We took our eyes up off of Jesus. So we don't have no peace because our peace is not stayed on Jesus. You're buffeted on every side.
Yes, Holy Spirit.
All the concerns of the world is weighing you down. You done tried everything else. You done been to every club. You done been to the witch doctor, because some of y'all been going to see the tarot card man. I don't need you to say, I know what I know. That wasn't the answer. That didn't get you nothing but a little bit of turmoil and trouble and some stuff. Now that you got to go before God and denounce, amen, amen. You done tried everything else. I heard the psalmist say this morning, I surrender all. What is it that you need to give up?
Yes,
to put him back on the throne.
Yes, God.
On the right hand of the Father.
Yes, Lord.
Interceding for you daily. What is it that you need to cast down? What is it that you need to separate yourself from? What is it that you need to walk on up out of that way? What is it that is making you take your eyes off Jesus on this morning? Come back in that same old place again. I'm chasing that same fluffy tail. Lord, what have I done? Our priorities need to change. Our focus needs to be on the real reason. Not just in the month of December, but 365 days of the year. He's the only one that can step in and change your situation around. He is the only one that can make the bitter experiences sweet. He's the only one that can put a hedge of protection around you that the enemy can't touch you. He's the only one that can put the blood on the north, south, and east, and west. He is the only one. He is the reason for the season. As I was even looking at some things, amen, I was reading where he bore the sins of many. Isaiah 53 and 12 says, therefore I will divide him a portion with the great, and he shall divide the spoils with the strong, because he hath poured. He done took this lady in his house, she done had a baby out of wedlock, and he still want to be with her. You know people was talking. about marriage, but we don't want to talk about the integrity and the character of Joseph. Because, see, the betrothalment meant 365 days. He just said, come on, we're going to cut that off right now. I need you to come and stay with me now. To not know his wife, but to take care of his wife. Without any doubt, without any hesitation, he woke up for the dream and he packed up his stuff. He said, we're getting up out of here. I'm going to get what is mine. I just thought that that was very important for us to know about what goes about for marriages back in them days in Jewish culture. Amen. And the contract that they signed. Because we need to understand that God is legal.
Amen.
He's a legal God. And Mary did come here. She was a virgin child. Amen. But it was legal because technically they were married. Amen. So I don't want us to forget about that because we start talking all some stuff. It was good to be able to talk to go do a study. Amen. On Joseph. But then it just started talking to me about people and their obedience and our integrity and our character. Amen. Can the Lord trust you with something so severe? Can he trust you with something so dear for you not to deviate from the plan and do what he's asked you to do? Amen. So as I was sitting here and I was reading all this stuff, amen, it was talking about even how Jesus carried the burdens of humanity. When we go to Isaiah 53 and 4, it says, surely he hath borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we did not esteem him, stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. And I keep going back to these things because we need to know why we should have the praises of the Lord on our lips continually. Amen. It's all about Jesus. He came, amen, so that you and I could have life and have life more abundantly. Amen. He came so that he could save his people, so that our sins could be forgiven. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Does anybody want to? The Bible says, whatsoever ye shall ask in my name, and what will I do that the Father may be glorified in the Son? If ye shall ask in anything in my name, I will do it.
Yes.
Not praying amiss, but if you ask in the name of Jesus, because you can't do nothing without his name. His name has to be attached to everything you do, or everything you ask for is null and void.